Good morning, class. Today we're going to be extending our knowledge of quadratics by focusing on a real-world problem, specifically of shooting a rocket from a platform. By the end of today, students will be able to solve for the initial height, the maximum height, and when this rocket will hit the ground, given the quadratic equation in factored form. Some questions that students will be answering are, how do you solve for the vertex point, axis of symmetry, roots, x-intercept, y-intercept, and what does that mean when we're talking about the initial height, maximum height, and when the rocket will hit the ground? All today in Escobar's class. Good morning, everyone. Today with 4.39, quadratics and contracts, the vertex form. We're going to start off by just referring back to our graph that we did yesterday. See, we have our initial value that will lead when we're going to start with our initial value, which is when we, right before we shoot the rocket, or in this case, right before we shoot the t-shirt, we're at a point when the amount of seconds we are given is zero. Good morning, everyone. We're going to start with lesson 4.39, quadratics and contacts, vertex form. Before we begin, I would like to share this graph again as a little recap. That here we have the initial point when there is 0 seconds of having shot this cannon or t-shirt, and which will lead to the maximum point, or the vertex, maximum height. This will eventually lead to when it hits the ground, or the x-intercept. Okay, so let's go with example one now. Example one, a t-shirt was launched out of those t-shirt cannons from a platform, right? You see in a basketball game. Its height in meters, 8 seconds after launch, is modeled by the equation h of x equals negative 5 times the quantity of x minus 4 squared plus 180. Alright, so going into part A, how high is the platform? So when we ask again, we're talking about the height. That is our y-intercept. Just like we learned before, when the initial value, the height was the platform, we're going to solve it here. And so by doing that, we must know that x equals 0. So we're then going to take this equation and then solve for the height when x equals 0. And after substituting x for 0, we end up getting negative 5 times the quantity of 0 minus 4 squared plus 180, in which when we subtract in the parentheses, square the parentheses, multiply by the parentheses, and then add our final results, we found that the height of the platform is at 100 meters. So now, moving into part B, after how many seconds will the object reach its maximum height? Well, we know that the maximum height is going to be that vertex point, HK. And because we're in vertex form, we can look at the equation and identify what that vertex point might be. What I like to do is take what's inside this parentheses, right? Because we're going to result in that H value. Separate it. X minus 4 equals 0. In which when we add 4 to both sides, x equals 4, so our highest point of the x-coordinate is 4. And because we know that the k value in our formula is 180, we can determine that h equals 4, k equals 180, therefore our maximum height, our maximum, our vertex point is 4, 180. Okay, so when they ask how many seconds will the object reach the maximum height, it will be 4 seconds. And that what that maximum height will be? 180. Now let's go into part C. After how many seconds will the t-shirt hit the ground or go to first row? Okay, so how many seconds? We're solving for our x variable because that is the unit for x. Then hitting the ground, well, that is when the height is 0, or h of x equals 0, in which we're solving for the x intercept or roots. Therefore, just like yesterday, we're substituting h of x, that equals 0, anchoring that into our given equation, resulting in z equals negative 5 times the quantity of x minus 4 squared plus 180. Okay, so because h of x equals 0, we substitute that whole term in for 0 and then solve for x. I want to subtract 180 to both sides. Therefore, I'm now left with negative 180 equals negative 5 times the quantity x minus 4 squared. I need to get rid of that coefficient in a. So I divide negative 5 to both sides, resulting in 36 equals x minus 4 squared. I want to get rid of this squared, so I do the inverse operation of that, which is by square rooting. Square root of 36 is positive and negative 6, which equals x minus 4. When I add 4 to both sides, I then result of x equals negative positive 6 plus 4. But because I'm having two terms, I need to separate this whole solution into two separate equations and solve for the exact value of x. So that's what we did. Plus positive 6 plus 4 equals x, in which 10 equals x. So there's 10 seconds from which the t-shirt hit the ground, or the first row, in which we have now the point 10, 0. But also, negative 6 plus 4 equals x, in which we get negative 2 equals x, so that's negative 2 seconds, or the point negative 2, 0. Technically, this is correct, but in the context, we can never have negative 2 seconds, so just like yesterday, this is an extraneous solution. It is a false solution. Okay, extraneous. And there we go.
Great job, everyone. That is all the time that we have for today. Make sure you answer the questions to problem set A, problem set B, and the exit ticket. Remember, the credit is in showing the work, not the results. Also, thank you all for everyone for labeling and submitting your classwork, homework, and notes with the appropriate tags. In addition, thank you all for those who are submitting your work before 4:30 p.m. You definitely receive those extra credit points. If you're not able to, again, just make sure you submit it by 11:59 p.m. today.